Big Superb Records. This is a wonderful record. It's just come out and it's two amazing artists who have worked together. We welcome Robert Plant and Alison Krauss. Lovely to see you.
Thank you too.
This is a fantastic record. I mean, it really is a great record. People are going mad about it in reviews. People are playing it in their homes, in their cars. But what I want to know is, how did you both meet? You seem from different worlds to me.
I was invited to play a testimonial benefit for the music of Lead Belly at the Rock and Roll Museum in Cleveland, Ohio, about, I don't know how long ago it was.
About 3 years ago.
Mm. And a mutual friend of ours suggested that we might try and do something together, and it would be appropriate to try some harmonies on a Lead Belly kind of theme. So we got together in Cleveland, and it worked, didn't it?
Yeah. It sounds fantastic. When were you first aware of Robert? What was your first being aware of Robert in your life? Were you a Zepp fan?
Yeah, I don't know if I remember not being aware of Robert and his music. My brother was very much into Led Zeppelin, and I would hear him screaming from his room, "I can't understand how this could be so good. I don't know what to do with myself." You know, I'd hear him in his room, and I was more aware of Robert's music from MTV and the things he did in the 80s, like, you know, Big Log and In the Mood, and I remember him from those days and from my brother.
Yeah, well, it's good. And you've both got a huge, fantastic history of your own. How did you choose what songs you should do for this record?
Oh, well, that's where our father comes into it, T-Bone Burnett. Our daddy came along, and I guess, really, we wouldn't have had the kind of the historical overview that he's got of American music. Alison's blue comes from the world of bluegrass and mountain music, and I was into Black New Orleans and Chicago blues and the stuff from Clarksdale. But he came out with some such amazing songs, and he sent us a kind of thesis about each song, didn't he?
Listen, we've got a little clip here. Let's just have a look. We've got a clip of you together, I hope, here.
Some sunny day, baby, seems okay, baby. You wake up and find that you're alone. 'Cause I'll be gone.
My boogie muscle going.
You need to look after that.
Yes, I know. My boogie muscle rushes around my body, operating in strange ways. Did you? There's a great track about Sister Rosetta Tharpe on there as well, which is great. And you quoted some of her lyrics. Did you write that song?
No, that's a song written by Sam Phillips.
Oh, wow, is that right?
Yes, the last song that we found for the record, we thought we didn't have quite all the material we needed, and T-Bone found that one, and we thought, what a beautiful song. It sounded like nothing I'd ever heard before.
Yeah.
I saw it at Birmingham Town Hall when I was 15, and I went backstage. I was a real groupie, anything to do with blues and gospel, and I remember being in the dressing room with Sonny Terry and Brandy McGee and Rosetta Tharpe, and she said, "Hey, you're a sweet boy. You want to come and help me do some stuff around the place?" And she told me to get on the coach and go with her to the next town. And then I joined Led Zeppelin.
Yeah, exactly. That was where it all started. Yes. Sister Rosetta Tharpe. Speaking of Led Zeppelin, you're about to do a huge reunion show. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are worried because they think it's going to take you away from some of this. Are you likely to? You, it's not going to take you away.
No. This is what it is. You know, it's going to be a great night at the O2. But we had to do something. Ahmet Ertegun, when he passed away, there was a huge move to try and do something to show benefit and credit to the man, to bring his profile. I mean, when we were signed to Atlantic Records, it was like, you know, he'd signed Ray Charles, Aretha Franklin, The Drifters, The Coasters, Ruth Brown, Big Joe Turner, yeah, from your boogie world. I mean, it was sensational. So to do something to say goodbye to Ahmet and to have so many other friends join us on that night is very appropriate because, I mean, he was a real thing, you know.
Well, there we go. I've learned a lot, and the new record is so fantastic. I hope that we can hear some more. And a lot of people say, well, wait a minute, why aren't they playing on the show? It's only because of Paulson, your band isn't here, so
yeah.
But it didn't work out. Will you be doing any shows together here?
God willing, yeah. Oh, talking about coming back in Windsor.
It's
spring, I thought.
Well, I hope so. Well, we're looking forward, we'd love to see it. And if, all I can say is if you haven't got this record, go and purchase it and it'll enhance your life. Thank you very much, Robert Plant and Alison Krauss. Now, we go to the world of Dorset, and over there we welcome the wonderful PJ Harvey.